Hey, good evening everybody, and welcome to my third Aviation Daily Information. As for today, we are going to speak about a popular component in the aircraft, which is the power transfer unit, or the PTU. You know that the power transfer units do exist in the aircraft to give an auxiliary source of pressure to more than one system. For example, if the aircraft are containing three hydraulic systems, this is for redundancy, system number one and system number three may be connected with the power transfer unit. Just in case any of them are suffering from a low pressure scenario, the power transfer unit and the properly functioning system will do power the degraded system. And here is the point for today. The PTU will only need to operate if the fluids exist in the two connected systems. So if a system suffers from a low pressure scenario, the fluids exist. So the PTU will operate and have sense to be operated in order the properly functioning system to operate or give a power to the degraded system. Is there another scenario for this? Yes. It is vice versa. It is another scenario where the power transfer unit need to be switched off. Otherwise, the PTU will malfunction the properly functioning system. What is this scenario? It is a leak scenario. If, for example, system number one do suffer from a leak, the PTU need to be switched off. Otherwise, if it does operate, it will overheat the other system or the properly functioning system, and the pilot will lose system number one and system number three. This is our point for today. For the PTU, there is two operation scenario. One, low pressure scenario, the PTU will need to be operated. The other one, a leak scenario, the PTU need to be switched off. This is my information for today. And if you need to know more, I'm having a training session on my channel regarding the dual hydraulic loss scenario, which exists if the PTU are not switched off in a leak scenario of a hydraulic system. Thank you, my friends, and wish you a good luck.